match. Defense was close. All around you, there was nowhere to go.
The Steelers' defense comes onto the field after surrendering a touchdown on the last drive.
Well, they're hoping for better results. No question about that, Jim. They got to come out. They got to hustle. There was not enough hustle last time. On his way.
Going to take it home for the touchdown.
Anytime you see a long run for a touchdown, what you got to look for is blocking downfield. Nice job by the wide receivers and everybody hustling, making a block and a long touchdown.
Extra point is good. The Steelers' return team has been on the field way too often today as they are getting blown out. The score's 21-0. That brings the play to an end. That return's good for about 24. The Chiefs' defense, Phil, has been the story of this game.
Yeah, so few words. That's not like you. Usually it takes more words than that to describe what's going on. But you're right. They've been dominating physically, just getting it done. And if they keep this up, there's no way the other team's going to win.
First down at the 17. Roethlisberger. DeVito with the sack.
And his defensive end, Jim, he is some talent. That time, good job, makes the move, shows the speed, and gets around there and gets the sack.
Airing it out. One-handed, makes the grab.
Round such. Great athlete, and of course you got to be a great athlete to be able to make a catch like that.
Let's see how they back up the big play here. Oh, and almost picked off that time.
You got to try to avoid this as a quarterback. Don't throw off that back foot unless you have to. When you do, there's just no way you're going to be as good if you had good balance. That time, the throw's off the mark.
Roethlisberger comes out in the pistol. Second down and 10. Fights through contact. Derek Johnson rushing in and takes him down. The Steelers on offense here to start the second quarter. Third down now. Quarters formation here for the defense. And the second quarter is underway with this snap. They bring back out the offense to go for it. The Chiefs defense brings in an extra member of the secondary. They'll go nickel. The Steelers turn the ball over on downs.
Good job by the defense that time. Fourth down, they were ready for everything. Very aggressive, fast. They make the play, and this could change the game around.
The Chiefs take the field again on offense. They'll be looking for a repeat of their last drive. They came away with a touchdown and really had the defense on its heels.
Well, it's going to be hard to repeat what they just did because it looked so easy and it was well done by their offense.
And in stride, and he's home for the touchdown.
touchdown. Feel like you're stealing something. It takes good blocks, but most importantly, it takes a talented running back to get it done, and this team definitely has one.
The Steelers set to return the kick. Takes off from the five. And he's tackled right at the 30-yard line after that return. The Steelers have failed to come away with points on three consecutive drives. Their offense takes the field again now. What's caused them to go silent here, partner?
Listen, let's give all the credit to the defense. They're being very creative on the defensive side. The coach is calling the right plays, and they are just taking it to the offense right now. The more aggressive team is winning, and that's the defense.
After the incomplete pass, it brings up second down. Bell in the backfield, single back set. Miller's got the catch and the first. That's his first reception today.
Roethlisberger's job is to sell that play fake, and boy, did he do it that time. It fooled the defense, and they get the completion.
First down coming up. They're back at the line after that catch for a first down. Looking to go down the field here. And they can't connect.
Always protect against the deep ball first. That's what the defense did this time. They were alert. Nice job. The result, just a long incompletion.
The Steelers take it from the 43. Martavis Bryant makes the catch. Now they take the football onto the opponent's side of the field. And the defense will use one of its timeouts right here.
Well, when you play this type of defense where you play cover three, in other words, you have three defenders playing one in the middle, one right, one left. Well, the weakness of that defense is going to be underneath. So slant patterns, they're pretty easy against this cover three.
First down at the 45. Roethlisberger's gonna scramble. Roethlisberger's gonna slide, and that'll end the play.
That's a really smart job that time by the quarterback. Pick up all the yards you can, and before you're gonna get hit, slide in there like you're going to second base.
The line of scrimmage, the 32-yard line. First down at the 32. Roethlisberger sends it to Bell. Ball is out.
Well, the one thing we know about the NFL, when you have the football in your hands, they are going to attack it.
Hold on a minute. They're going to stop play and take another look at that last one. So they're looking to see if the ball came out before the knee was down.
I think when you look at these plays, most of the time it's pretty easy to determine. Jim, you know, you can. It's just always a clear shot. When that knee hits the ground, you can freeze that shot and determine if it's a fumble or
after
down by contact.
The line on the field is reversed.
They went to the booth, and it was not verified. After nearly turning it over, it's second down. Just a quick drop back. Still on his feet. The ball is out. He's brought to a halt.
As a quarterback, you've got to know when to get rid of the football. That time, he just holds on it too long, takes the hit. and fumbles it. Bad job.
The Chiefs offense heading back onto the field to start the drive after the result of their last possession was a touchdown. You think they've got another one in them, partner?
Oh, I absolutely do. Well, I mean, just look at it. They got a good football team. The quarterback has great confidence and talent. And you put those things together, that makes you good. It makes you dangerous. And I wouldn't be surprised to see him march down there again.
Second down. Double tight end formation. Charles is going to secure the football on the toss. He's churning ahead. Charles is taken down at the 33. As we've seen today, this is a team that's dedicated to the run, and it's paid off with some very good stats on the ground.
Well, it shows you what the coach thinks. He believes in running the football, and when you believe in it, what happens to your football team? They become tough, and they have shown that toughness here today. That's why they have such a good ground game going.
Charles takes the hit and is brought down. The Chiefs would love to run the ball like they have so far. Charles is taking the ball, and he's leading this team on the field right now.
Boy, he sure is. And I give him a lot of credit, but I also say this. The offensive line, anytime you see a running game go this well, you got to give a lot of credit to the O-line. Charles is a great running back to have on your football team, isn't he? He goes up in there and gets the first down. Now your offense has three more chances.
Smith will have it in the pistol. First down at the 35. Thomas all over that offense and brings him down.
Good job by the defense. They stopped the first down play that time by the offense, and now they have a good situation.
The line of scrimmage, the 36. Second down and 12. Wilson's got it on a pass that had some heat. All the way home and all alone. Touchdown. And we've reached the 2-minute warning.
Before I say goodbye, I'd like to say good day. And I hope you say goodbye when they ask, was it worth for you to pay? For my music, for pressing play, for all the stress that went into my songs, my love and hate. The most honest I could be with you to date is to say thank you, Shady, for letting me be me with no holes for this old job. When there's but two fine lines on a blank sheet, but so far, these two lines point out, valet UFOs, I go par. The Dirty South needs a soap bar in the mouth of these MCs, but who am I to judge on what they love? I guess they enjoy being broken co-stars. And I'm soaking so hard from the sweat that I could take my clothes off. And the whole yard should sit back and shake the dough off. But I'm already gone. I got a vision like telephones in an envelope like letters, lettuce, green, money, loan. Wolf packs in the cow's home. I'll keep making these sound bones. Yeah, you might have heard a dial tone, but I was on the other line when I hung up the phone. I send a postcard when I leave. And think about you when I dream. And when I'm up under the high beams, I reflect that shining. So you can feel the heat of light and life of fire, the sun of dying. Yeah, I done come a long way from Dixieland. Take my hand.
I'm talking low riders, 77 defeaters, L dogs, nothing but them legs.
Sitting on blast in the front yard of the trailer park.
I'm already ready.
Ready.
And they wonder why I speak this way. And you ain't never seen this place. Well, here's your American pie. It's a Dixie piece of cake.
Hello, everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. We've got a good one on tap today, and there's going to be two quarterbacks ready to get it done on the gridiron. It's Smith's Chiefs going up against Bradford's Eagles. Now let's get you out to Arrowhead Stadium, where Jim Nance and Phil Simms have the call.
Eagles, Chiefs on EA Sports, Kansas City, Missouri, the site for today's matchup.
Hello, friends. Jim Nance along with Phil Simms. And, Phil, it's an absolutely gorgeous day here for football. And how will that factor into this game?
You're right, Jim. It is a beautiful day. And with days like this, the best team usually wins because the weather is going to have no effect on all the talent on the field. The throwers and catchers and ball carriers, they don't have to worry about the elements. They can just go out there and show the talent.
The Chiefs ready here for the kickoff. Huff's going to be back deep here on the opening kick. We're underway here. Huff's got it. Taken down at the 39. That return's good for about 35. Leading this offense today is the number one overall selection in a 2010 draft out of Oklahoma, Sam Bradford.
Sam Bradford, when he came out of Oklahoma, I thought he was one of the purest throwers I've ever watched in college football. Give him protection, he can still get it done.
Defense calls a timeout. Almost to the 40 at the 39-yard line. Murray lined up in the backfield. First down at the 39. And the flag is down. Intercepted. The Eagles come out with a split backfield. The Eagles have it at the 29. And it's batted down.
DeMarco Murray had a monster season in 2014 for the Cowboys, and then Dallas lost him to free agency to the Eagles, Phil.
I think he could have a monster season for the Philadelphia Eagles, too. This is a very good offensive line, and they needed a running back who was more physical, and they got him in DeMarco Murray.
Derek Johnson is a man who makes so many tackles for this Chiefs defense.
I watched Derek Johnson in college for the University of Texas. He was making tackles all the time down there, and he has continued that process even in the NFL.
The Chiefs with a nickel look here on defense. The Eagles have it at the 29. Looking to go deep. And they can't connect.
Well, the quarterback that time tried to squeeze it into tight coverage, but no can do. The coverage is too good, and the football falls incomplete.
Eagles will risk it here, going for it on fourth here in the first quarter. The Eagles have to get to the 49 for a first. going deep. Oh, the receiver turns around and defends the pass and takes away what would have been a pick. Smith's heading out now for his first series. Great starting field position for the offense. Smith's got two tight ends on the field for this snap. The Chiefs have it at the 29. Outside now on the toss. What a run by Charles.
This gives an offense a lot of momentum. It gives everybody confidence. This running back, he's sitting there going, keep giving it to me, man, because I can make it happen.
How you perform inside the red zone is often the difference in a game, and we'll get an early taste of that.
No doubt about it, Jim. You got to be creative when you get in the red zone. We'll see what the offense calls.
Almost intercepted. For the offense today, one of the quickest running backs the league has ever known, Jamaal Charles.
He's quick, he's fast, he's underrated, he's underappreciated. What can you say about Jamaal Charles? I think I just said it all.
Second and goal from the 8. And now here's the toss. Swallowed up behind the line of scrimmage.
Jim, it's third and goal. This is a big spot here early in today's game. Now the defense, if they can stop the offense here, boy, that will be a big lift.
Third and goal from the 9. Still not taken down. Sherman's brought down after picking up 6 on this play. Smith with the power surge. Touchdown.
You kind of plan these situations out before the game if you're the coach. You know, if you get the down here, it's fourth and goal. You've already decided you're going to be aggressive. They were this time, and they get the touchdown.
Huff's going to test the coverage here. Going to take it the distance. The 20, the 10, and he's in for the touchdown. What a play. What a run.
When you get a kick return for a touchdown, a lot has to happen. One, it takes talent by the kick returner. But look at all the good blocks we saw down the field and the speed of the kick returner. Touchdown.
The Eagles can tie it up with the point after. Add the extra point. The kick is good. Now ready to kick it off as we have a tie game here. Scores 7-7. The Chiefs are anxious to return the kickoff. march down the field and in a hurry, and they stop the returner right away.
What a job by the kickoff team. The hustle, everybody sprinting down the field, and they get rewarded. They give great field position to their defense.
The Chiefs offense preparing to get this drive underway. The last possession ended in a touchdown. Phil, let's see if they can do it again.
Very well done. Love what I saw out there on the offense the last time. They mixed it up and they showed a lot of confidence. You can see the speed of the football team and try to duplicate what they just did.
Personal foul. Face mask.
Boy, his head got yanked back the other way. An obvious face mask penalty, and that's a big one.
It's about safety of the players, too. That's why when you grab, hit the helmet in certain situations, it's going to be a 15-yard penalty. Don't grab the face mask.
Is a very smart runner. He knows situations in the game. He saw the first down yard markers, and what does he do? He gets past them and picks up the first down.
First and goal from the 8. Davis handed the football. Smash it to the right side.
You've got linebacker Kiko Alonso, who was part of that offseason trade for LeSean McCoy.
That's right. They needed help at the linebacker position, and Alonso can run. He's a good tackler. He's going to fit in well for the Eagles' defense.
Midway through the first, they're going to run it on the toss. And that's a two-yard gain.
Say this to the quarterback. It's third. Go. If the play's not there, throw it away. Do not force the action.
Ready. Third and goal from the 6. Makes the catch. Touchdown.
Offside. Defense.
The penalty is declined. That last play will hold up. The Chiefs with an extra point try on the way. Good. The Eagles are prepared to return the kickoff. Got a chance for a return. And he's going to be brought down right around the 33-yard line. The Chiefs defense has to be looking across the line of scrimmage and saying, what were you guys thinking about the last time when you went for it on fourth down on your own side of the field?
I don't even know if they can concentrate. They're still laughing about the fourth down decision the time before. So come on, sharpen up on the offensive side.
Make some good decisions. This is like life.
Murray's trying to be patient, but there is nowhere to run that time, and he only gets a short gain.
Second down now. Had it for a moment, but then lost it on the hit.
That's interesting as you watch the receiver trying to make that catch. He knew the defender was close, so he didn't put all of his heart into it. The defender made a nice hit and knocked the football out to the ground.
The Eagles have it at the 34. And he's going to be dumped. And that's a three and out. The Eagles from the 27. The Eagles turn the ball over on downs. The Chiefs offense ready to continue its recent run here as they've scored the last two times they've had it, Phil.
Well, let's look at it from the defensive side. What do you think they're thinking? Oh, my gosh, what's coming next? Because everything the offense has tried so far has worked.
Keeps his legs moving. Gains 14.
What a good job by the running back that time. He reads the blocks very well, and he picks his way through there and picks up a first down. That's nice. Well, this early in the game, to watch the opposing offense march down the field and get inside the 20, this keeps the defense, they might be shaking a little. Field goal try or worse, that'll get their confidence back.
He gets into the end zone, capping off the long run. That touchdown has them sitting pretty as the first quarter winds to a close.
Wow, you know, something sitting pretty, something I've never done. But, you know, I do the best I can. That's all I can do, Jim. But, hey, the offense, the team, they're so sharp. What a job by them so far. They got a nice lead here.
Makes the PAT. The Chiefs getting set for the kickoff. Hucks got a chance to return this one. Going to be taken down at about the 33, maybe the 34-yard line. The Eagles really let it all hang out the last time they had the ball, Phil. They went for it on a fourth down in their own territory. Let's see if they're a little more conservative with this possession.
Well, you know, it's amazing. I want to see really a good defensive call by the defense. offensive coordinator, but let's be honest, when you're backed up and you go for it on fourth down, which situation like that, anybody could have made that call.
It'd be the first time I've ever agreed with the beat writer.
The Eagles have it at the 34. At the 34, 66 yards from pay dirt. Quick drop back. Derek Johnson rushing in and takes him down. Murray with the reception. And he's going to be tackled, and that's going to bring us the fourth down.
The Eagles go with a safe call here, but at least they get the completion.
The coach is going to go for it. Sam Bradford will be under center. The Eagles will take the snap from the 30. Pass is intercepted. He's brought down.
Nice job of the defense that time. In position, they read the quarterback's eyes, and it led to an interception.
The Chiefs' offense has been the rage here early in this game, and if this defense isn't careful, this game's going to be over in a hurry here, Phil.
Well, I got some ideas for the defense. Don't sit back anymore. Send the ball. Just catch the offense off guard. Blitz, send everybody.
Nobody was going to catch him there. Touchdown.
To me, still one of the most exciting plays in NFL football. A long running play for a touchdown. And how about that one? It had it all in its speed. Good moves, good blocks. Exciting touchdown.
And the point after is good.
The NFL on EA Sports is brought to you by Gatorade. Win from within.
Jim Nance, Bill Center at Arrowhead Stadium. Second quarter about to get underway. The Chiefs ready to boot the football down the field.
Well, of course, the team goes well. So they got to find a way to get him started. How do you do that? Is it a trick play? I don't know. But get him going. Tell that offensive line to toughen up, and this game will change around.
First down at the 25. Almost made the catch, but the collision jarred it loose. The Eagles have had a tough time moving the football through the air, and it's been part of the reason why they trail at this point. Bradford's struggled mightily, and they're going to need to get him going, Phil.
They are going to need to get him going. But listen, let's give the defense a little credit. It's not all about bad offense. The defense is on top of everything. They're playing very well, and I think the offense needs to change what they're trying to do.
And intercepted! Here we are in the second quarter, partner. Again, nothing is going right for this offense. This time throwing a pick.
Yeah, Jim, they can't find a play to get execution on and get something positive going for them. And, you know, when you get in situations like this, it's up to the coach to make the plays easy, to give the offense some confidence. That's what they need to do right now.
The Chiefs offense taking the field again. They got everything they could out of that last possession, Phil. That was a solid touchdown drive.
Yeah, just look at them, Jim. The way they run on the field, you can see they're exuding confidence. When you got a confident football team, man, let them go and let them play and see if they can make it happen again.
The Chiefs have stayed with the run game today, and it's been a big part of their game plan. Charles has been a consistent force on the ground.
Yeah, he's just a running back who never gives up. And when he runs, it's arms, elbows, everything is moving, and he is one tough running back to tackle.
The Chiefs take it from the 38. Looking long. Incomplete.
That's a wonderful job that time by the secondary. Everybody's in position. Nowhere for the quarterback to throw the football, and it leads to another incomplete pass.
The offense needs 6 yards here on third down after that incompletion. Third down and four. Here's the quick toss. Running room. A foot race to the end zone. Taking it all the way home for the touchdown.
How about the blocking up front? Lets the running back get in the secondary, and he is so quick and elusive, he avoids the tackles and takes it all the way for the touchdown.
The Eagles have really just been outplayed in every facet of this game. Really just looking for any sort of answer. The score is 35-7. Huff's going to start his return. And the tackle's made right around the 25-yard line. Derek Johnson retaking the field. Their defense has had a lot to do with them getting out to this lead, and he's been the one setting the tone, Phil.
Yeah, Jim, I love the way he plays. He's had a terrific day so far. His toughness, I think that's his greatest quality.
Here we go now.
The Eagles will take the snap from the 25. That's dropped by Cooper, who couldn't bring it in.
That incompletion by the quarterback, hey, I give the quarterback no fault. That was just tremendous coverage by the secondary player. He's in position and able to make the football be incomplete.
Second down following that incompletion. Cooper, who couldn't bring it in.
Third long situations, a lot of coordinators in this league will run a draw play on third long. Why? Because they're just looking for field position, pick up a few yards, and then by some miracle, if the running back's able to make guys miss, break some tackles, and pick up a first down, man, that's just great.
And it's incomplete. We're early in the second quarter, and this offense has struggled from the start, Phil.
Yeah, they've struggled here so far early in this game, Jim. But look, a long way to go. There's still a lot of plays on that play sheet. So start looking down there. Find some ones that work and give these players a chance to have some success.
The Eagles turn the ball over on downs.
Yeah, I love seeing plays like this. A fake punt when you throw the football and it doesn't work. Hey, it's easy to do these things in practice, but when you got to do it in the game, you can feel the pressure, you get tight, and sometimes you just cannot execute the play.
The Chiefs offense taking the field again. They got everything they could out of that last possession, Phil. A solid touchdown drive.
Yeah, what a productive day so far for the offense. They're mixing it up well. They got confidence. The quarterback's throwing it well. This is a very good game so far.
That's a timeout by the D. In a dangerous spot here. Backs to the end zone. Stepping up to the line at the six. The Eagles come out in a dime package. Toss play. Keeps his legs moving. He's in the clear. He's at the 50. Now at the 40. The 30. The 20. The 10. And in for the touchdown.
Don't see a lot of them anymore because we have so many good tackling safeties in the NFL, but not this time. That long run goes for a touchdown. It was about the moves and the blocks down the field. Terrific job by the offense.
The Eagles are prepared to return the kickoff. Huff's got it. Gets out past the 30. Brought down near the 35. The Eagles are experiencing a little bit of a drought here offensively, having gone three straight possessions without a score. What do you think needs to be done to buck that trend here, partner?
I'd say it's a little more than a drought. This is some awful offense, and there's many things you've got to do. You've got to tell your offensive line to pick things up. When the offensive line is aggressive, it gives all the stars a chance to succeed, and that's what they got to do here. Offensive line, get it going. Got to give the secondary credit. In this passing league now, it's hard to make plays, but a good play there and another incomplete pass.
The Chiefs lined up in the nickel. Second and 10. Looking long. And it's incomplete.
If you're defensive back in the NFL now, you alert for the deep passes downfield, because not only do you got to play it well, you got to